Hello, my name is Ellis Bright. In this video, we will show how to parameterize a CAD model in Inspire, which is the first step of our optimization methodology. We will do this in Inspire by utilizing the variable manager. In the variable manager, we will see different variables that we've defined as well as their values. Changing the values of our variables will change the look and design of our mixer. As we can see here, I'm changing the rows and columns of our mixer to change the number of paddles. We can also change their angle, their widths, and so forth. And this is the design parameter space that we will want to optimize on to get the best performance out of our mixer. The way we have defined our variables is through sketch and geometry tools. For example, here I've defined a variable for my stem diameter and given it a value of 40. For my paddles, I have defined a width as well as a thickness and an angle. I have two different types of paddles in my mixer, one for pushing the material forward and one for pushing it back to increase mixing uniformity. Each paddle has their own respective variables, which can be changed independently. In order to define the pattern of my paddles, I have used the linear pattern geometry tool. I have used the linear pattern tool to define the number of columns axially in my mixer. I have also used the circular pattern tool to define the amount of paddles radially. I have set a variable called rows to determine the number of paddles around my mixer. In order to import this geometry into our EDEM simulation, we'll need to export it as a STL mesh, and we'll need two files for that, first being a Python file using the Inspire Application Programming Interface, or API, to facilitate and automate updating variables and mesh generation. We will call our Inspire geometry model and import the necessary libraries. Once we have activated our model, we can use model.variables.update, specifying the variable name and the expression which relates to its value. The API has extensive functionality that allows for easy modification of the geometry. For example, we can combine all parts of the mixer and scale them down as shown here. We have then converted the part into a mesh and saved it as an STL. In order to execute this Python file, we'll need a batch file. Inside the batch file, we are calling the directory of our Inspire executable, as well as these flags to run it in the background. We will also specify our parameter script. Running this batch file will create an STL file based on the parameter inputs that we provided. The STL file will be created in the same folder as the parameter script and the batch file. In order to automate the creation of our STL mesh with different variable values, we will use HyperStudy. We will add a model and select the parameterize file. Under the resource tab, we will search for and select our parameters Python file. By parameterizing the Python script, we can change the value of each variable so that a geometry can be created without having to change the Python script. We will highlight the number in our expression and create a label and a name for our variables. And we will do this for each of the variables in our Python script. We will then save this as a template file for HyperStudy to read. Make sure to select Python for your solver execution script. We will call our batch file by adding a model operator. We will register a new solver for our batch file by selecting Add Solver Script. We will then select Other Application in the window. We can then select our batch file, click OK. Once we import our variables, we can now see the variables that were inside our Python script in the HyperStudy GUI, and we can easily change their values so that a specific configuration of our mixer is created. Once we run the definition, we will get a Python file inside our run folder with the specific values of the variables that we specified. We'll then go to the model resources, which will allow us to bring all the files together into one folder and automate the geometry generation. For the operator to execute the Python script, we'll copy it back by adding an output file, and we can then link it to our second model, which is our operator. We can now add our generic continuous mixer Inspire geometry and copy it over into our second model. This will allow the operator to call Inspire, executing the modified Python script so that a new geometry STL is created. We will change our input variables to check this and run the definition. Once the definition has been run, we can go again into our Explorer and see that an STL has been created automatically through HyperStudy with the variable values that we specified. We now have a method of creating mixer geometry meshes through HyperStudy and Inspire, which can then be imported into our EDEM model for simulation.